In the currency quadrant, taking a look at the June euro currency, which has moved higher for two consecutive sessions now, rising off of a seven-week low close by about 85 basis points, or between 0.8 and 0.9% so far. That's 0.85%. At the midweek mark, the euro is working on its first up week in the last four, up about a third of 1% after having dropped at one point during the course of the week by almost 0.6%. The low today was the same as yesterday's settlement, so it was unchanged, basically a straight up day, 107.97. The high, however, 108.69, that was up 0.2%, and we ended up settling a little bit closer to the high than the low, obviously quite a bit closer, up about 57 basis points. That's the New York close. EU data, we got some critical economic data out of the EU today, which included weaker core and headline year-over-year inflation rates for March, but a stronger month-over-month inflation rate, up 0.8%. The unemployment rate in the EU was also released, and it was unchanged from the previous month, but the previous month was also revised a little higher. The key thing, however, is the unemployment rate was data from February, and the inflation data was the flash data for March, so it was a little more current and therefore a little bit more important. We're also looking at general dollar weakness in the market. The dollar is lower again, two consecutive days, reflecting Fed rate cut expectations, which still remain at three cuts before the end of the year, even after Jerome Powell's speech today, in which he mentioned that 2% was still their inflation target. It's not only that the euro gained against the dollar today, but so did the Swiss franc, the Aussie dollar, the Kiwi, the Canadian dollar, and the pound. Overall, the euro ended up a little bit less than 0.6%.